those of you wondering why don't I eat as much food on my channel as I once did, and you'd be surprised how much a YouTuber's life, personal life, is affected by my creator life. Meaning, for example, the food and the timing of when I eat and everything that encompasses messed up my eating time and meal time with my husband. So that kind of evolved over a number of years, and it wasn't until the last year or so that I just felt so bad for my husband. Though he didn't say anything, I just felt the feeling was like, well, gee whiz, you know, your channel gets the best of you, and I'm here with the leftovers. And I say that simply because that's how I felt when he was a realtor back in the day, before retirement, and exactly how I felt. He gave his whole everything to real estate, and there's a lot of socializing that goes on with real estate, and he came home, he was just exhausted. So I've just cut back on the food for that reason. I would hate for him to feel that way, like I felt. So I've just cut back a little bit. I hope not to cut back completely, but it takes a lot of forethought to figure out when can I eat what I'm planning to want to eat on my channel that won't affect eating with as much joy and gusto as I do on camera. So that's what that's all about. Last night was tantamount night, and most of the time when he has a sandwich for supper versus a sandwich for lunch, it's a jumbo sandwich, and he likes to have Lay's potato chips with it and his artichokes. Every single meal for supper, we have a salad. He rotates between all his fun dairy-free salad dressings. I like to kind of stay with olive oil and salt and a teeny tiny bit of vinegar. He prefers to drink milk with his supper, and I flip-flop back and forth between the milk. When I say milk, I mean almond milk and straight Coca-Cola. It's terrible. And Lay's potato chips. There's something so wonderful about Coca-Cola and Lay's potato chips. I'm not crazy about the artichokes. I love my kosher dill pickles. So when we have a big sandwich night, that's what's going on. So I was tuning out. Oh, night before, Whopper, Burger King Whopper. Simply because McDonald's on the DoorDash app wouldn't let us order for that night. So I'm guessing when that happens periodically, they're swamped. They have so many orders and not enough workers, and they close down DoorDash for the night till the next day. So we opted. I originally wanted a Big Mac, opted for the Whopper. And we get it without the dressing, put our own dressing on it, and our own cheese. My husband is just so happy. He has to stay dairy-free or just doesn't feel well. And he really thought that was the end of his life. He wasn't going to be able to enjoy food as he had been. I found a mayo that is better than best foods, dairy-free. I found cheeses better than the sliced cheese that we have. And so just incorporate that into the restaurant burgers. Delicious. And a huge thing of french fries. I think we each had our own large thing of french fries. Terrible. Homemade salad. And a ton of pickles. So there's two nights in a row where we had sandwiches, which is kind of unusual. And we had such a good time. Whereas prior, had I been eating something on my video for that day, I would have ruined the whole supper experience. Day before, this has kind of been fun lately. I've been getting those ribs, those baby back ribs from Jack Daniels has a thing, a bag of ribs that are pre-cooked. All you do is warm them up. Oh my goodness, they're so good if you don't overcook them and dry them out. And so we had ribs, and shame on me. I only bought one pack thinking he'll have 3/4 of it and I'll have a quarter. And I could tell he could have eaten like the whole thing. So let me write that down. I'm gonna do those ribs again. I'm just gonna get two. I think they're like $14 or $15 a package, but it's so worth it. Oh my goodness, you can probably get the same thing as a restaurant. You're gonna pay even double, and it's so simple, just pop it in the oven. And you know me, Walmart, best pricing. One day they were out at the Jack Daniels, and we ended up with the Kingsford. I stick with the Kingsford for me because I realized it had gluten. I have to be so careful with what products have gluten in. Some barbecue sauces have gluten. Terrible. So on that night, we had salad with the ribs, and a side of baked beans and corn on the cob. Oh my goodness, so much fun. That was that. And ribs. Before that was tacos. I think I finally found the healthiest taco meat for both my husband and myself. It's a taco sauce mix that people would normally use as like a taco sauce. You just add that to your taco. So in an effort to find a gluten-free and dairy-free taco mix, I just experimented with the sauce into the meat. Delicious. It's over the top good. So, that was the night we had tacos. It's just like a serve yourself with all this stuff there, the taco meat. And I always make a thing of guacamole with avocados, smash it up, a thing of tortilla chips on the side, cheese, shredded cheese, cut up lettuce. There's a salsa, a red tomato salsa. And on taco nights, we always have Coke. My husband does prefer RC Cola, so I try to get that for him when I think of it. And those are the nights we have straight Coke or straight Cherry Coke. And I think I mentioned this a week or two ago for desserts. We have been having crushed pineapple with coconut whipped topping and have stayed away from ice cream, which is like a miracle. And so to make it fun for my husband, I have the crushed pineapple. I drained the juice. Like, I kind of think it's nicer with the juice drained, with a lot of whipped topping, the coconut whipped topping. And I always put a cherry on top of the stem. He gets such a kick out of that. It's just a fun little treat. And every once in a while, I forget. It's not that I forget. I purposely don't put the cherry on top. And he finally figured it out. He was just saying, you forgot the cherry. And he figured out I wasn't forgetting it. I was just doing that to get his attention. But I've said it before, you can have so much fun with whipped cream, whipped topping, and a cherry. It's just a fun food item. Okay. Let's see. Oh my goodness, White Castle. Unfortunately, I can't do the White Castle thing because of the gluten in the bun. He is so addicted to those White Castle burgers, and I like to tease them sometimes. You get 6 in a package, but I give him 3, and what I do to get rid of so much of the bread, so much of the carbs, is just combine the meat. So each White Castle burger has 2 meat patties. I don't think I ever shared this. Most of the time, we don't eat at the family summer table. We eat in front of the TV, and I serve him with a tray. I walk in with his tray of food and serve him on his little table tray in front of his chair. We have the best time. And once in a great while, I'll joke with him and say, I am so sorry. I ate one of your White Castles. And the first time or two, you could tell he was just sick. Well, of course, he knows it's just a trick now, so. And I never really eat it. I have my own, but like I said, it's not the real White Castle. It's meat that I've taken from the White Castle. And then all those buns. My daughter occasionally will use them for a sandwich or a little slider. So on White Castle night, we have that with pickles, salad, french fries. We used to watch movies and different assorted things as we ate. And we realized the most enjoyable dinner atmosphere for us is watching Lawrence Welk. I know it just sounds so corny, but it's so relaxing and enjoyable. I guess you just have to be there to enjoy it, but 99% of the time we're watching Lawrence Welk, having supper. And it's a PBS program, so there's no commercials. Completely fun without the commercials. So there's that. There's our White Castle night. And again, on the years that I did a lot of eating on my channel, those nights kind of crumbled into, I would serve, bring his food in, and I'd be with him as he ate, but I didn't eat because I was just full. I'd eaten too much during the day. That wasn't fun. That's not a fun part. Chicken enchiladas. That's a fun supper. We have that maybe once or twice a month. My daughter makes the best chicken enchiladas. We found delicious gluten-free, dairy-free salsas and sauces for enchiladas. So when we have that, we have a salad, but on the side we have homemade guacamole with tortilla chips. And we prefer the On the Border tortilla chips, our favorite. The cafe, the thin ones, I think they call them, the cafe chips. Oh, we're back to the Filet-O-Fish, McDonald's Filet-O-Fish. Through DoorDash, I get him a double Filet-O-Fish, no cheese, no sauces, and it comes home, and I put his favorite dairy-free cheese with no sauce. We make our own tartar sauce. Oh my goodness. He's in Filet-O-Fish heaven. French fries. And so on the nights that he's having, like on Whopper night, I had a Whopper, but I couldn't eat the Whopper bun, so I had my own gluten-free bun. It's okay. It's not nothing like a real Whopper, but again, just the fact that I'm there eating with him is the fun part. And I do the same thing with the fish. I'm not sure what kind of batter is on their fish. I'm sure it's probably got gluten in it. So I only have one and I try to scrape the batter off, but ideally I need to not eat that anymore. I think it does have gluten. But love the fries. And we have pickles with that, or artichokes. I think he likes artichokes. I always end up with pickles. Oh my goodness, deli sandwich night. Mortadella. I am so addicted to mortadella still. He loves a deli sandwich with mortadella, cheese, salami, thinly sliced tomatoes, thinly sliced onions, sometimes lettuce, sometimes not, mayo, Dijon mustard, a little bit of deli sauce, but I use Italian salad dressing. It's like a deli sauce, oh my goodness, with Lay's potato chips and Coke, a salad on the side, and we're in deli sandwich heaven. And the reason a lot of these sandwiches end up for dinner is I think it should be the opposite. We should eat the bigger meal at lunch and the light meal at supper. We've switched it around. We have a light breakfast, a light lunch, and a jumbo supper. Terrible. And when he snacks during the day, this is hysterical. Every day he has to have a snack of peanut butter and crackers with a glass of milk. And you know what my snack is? This is the worst. Those gluten-free Oreo cookies with a glass of milk. The only thing I can say is I used to have 3 of the cookies with a glass of milk. Now I only need 1 of the cookies with a glass of milk. So there might be hope. And each day we have that one snack that we look forward to. It's terrible. And my husband, he puts the biggest glob of peanut butter on each cracker, and he tops it off with best food. I can't handle that. The peanut butter, yes, but maybe peanut butter and jelly on cracker, but not peanut butter and best food. And I'd say, so that's our deli sandwich night. And of course, spaghetti night's always fun. Huge bowl of spaghetti. And I flip-flop back and forth between sausage and the spaghetti sauce. So it's a meat sauce. Sometimes I use hamburger. But mostly I think we enjoy sausage and the sauce. Sometimes I make meatballs. That's usually what my husband prefers, and I think he mostly prefers the Italian sausage with a salad. And let's see. Oh, we've been having steak and cheese sandwiches few months back, he saw the commercial for Subway. They were showing off their steak and cheese. He had to have one. So we got two. Oh my goodness, they were just sad. And I said, sweetheart, lover of mine, I can make you the best steak and cheese sandwich ever. And so that's what I do. I get the, you know, the sirloin steak, the steak meat that you would use for Philly cheesesteaks. I get the Walmart brand. They are way more better tasting than they, like even the famous Steakums. With his favorite cheese, I put double, triple cheese in there, a ton of the meat, lots of mayo, and I even fry up the bell peppers and onions and throw that in there. Oh my goodness, it's steak and cheese sandwich heaven for him, and me too. Don't forget the Wendy's chili. We have that a couple times a month. And as I've mentioned before, we use that kind of like as a base. And I throw a ton of meat in there, hamburger meat. I throw salsa in there. One time I added corn, canned corn in there. Kidney beans. So it seems like every time we have Wendy's chili in the can from Walmart, real happy with it. Oh, tons of cheese and onions. And he loves garlic bread. I do homemade garlic bread with the chili. And our homemade garlic bread is the San Luis sourdough bread with butter. And that cheese spread, boursin. Or brewers. It starts with a B. Spread that on top and then sprinkle parsley flakes on top. Oh my goodness. Better tasting than any store-bought Texas toast. I do the same garlic bread with a spaghetti and meatball night. Oh, lobster night. Usually it's king crab night. I think my husband and I both love king crab more so than the lobster. Costco has the best buy on the biggest king crab, same with the lobster. And so once or twice a month, I just go to Costco just for the crab or just for the lobster. Come home and have it that night with butter and rolls on the side or garlic bread. He loves a barbecue tri-tip from Wood Ranch. So when we have barbecue tri-tip night, I always want to order out for Wood Ranch because he loves it so much. I'm happy with that Costco sirloin, pre-cooked, but so we'll have barbecue tri-tip, baked potato, tons of butter and cheese on top, garlic bread, garlic rolls, and a salad, and all baked beans. Of course, we still have Big Mac night. I'm so happy he still loves like the fun, traditional things we had growing up. Old-fashioned Big Mac. Let's see. Barbecue chicken sandwiches. Usually it's barbecued pork rib sandwiches. Have some of the rib meat left over from red rib night and make a barbecue sandwich. Oh my goodness, BLTAs. I'm getting so good at making his BLTAs now. Of course, you've seen the bacon the other morning, my bacon video. That's kind of what gave me the idea when I was making this bacon. And So I did double. That was a morning bacon. I did double because I knew he was going to eventually want BLT sandwiches. And so for breakfast, we also enjoy the pepper and onion, bright pepper and onions. And I sprinkle cheese in it, delicious. And I fry it in the bacon grease. It's terrible. It's so good. And breakfast for me is bad. Coffee and donuts, coffee and cookies, terrible. My husband, though, does prefer, like, eggs and toast. So it kind of varies with him. Sometimes sausage, those, you know, those pre-cooked breakfast sausages. But a little part of a banana. Yeah, breakfast is real bad for me. So that's kind of just a nutshell. I don't have everything here. I think this was like the quickie. List. Now you know. I'm wondering how come Angela's not eating like a crazy woman anymore. That's why. That's just something that kind of just happened over the years that I got so eating so much on camera, and it wasn't fun eating.